this tutorial I show you how to use a transparent image. The type file image, it's a PNG image. This image can use alpha transparency and can be used in many game engine and for graphics. Let's start with part. You need to scan this part and make some changes in the properties parameters. First, let's make a good color, white, and select transparency to 1. Now, the next step is to add the image using a decal. The decal can take a texture. I add two images, a pine branch and a snow flare. Let's start with snow flare. And you can see the part has the image with a transparency background of a snow flare. Let's change this image with another one with the PNG transparency, the pine branch, and you can see this is add with transparency also. You can play this Roblox game and you can see it's easy to see from one side. This is because I use a part with the decal on this face, and if I go on the back of a part, I don't see the decal. Let's fix this issue. So, how can I add object in the Roblox game with double transparent image? I use a mesh part. I add the mesh ID. Basically, it's open to the wave object exported from Blender. I select the pine branch transparent image with a transparency with 0.1, and let's see how this looks. You can see this mesh part, it's very easy to use it. Now you can move it or you can scale this mesh part. Now I will show you how I create and export this mesh object from Blender. I use it Blender version 3.1.0, the experimental version from release from 1st December. You can see I have old graphic card. This is not very good for rendering. In this Blender file I have default camera light and I add the plane. The plane has surface material. This is default material using the shading. The material has principled BSDF material, and I import a pine branch png file type from my hard disk. It's an image from web, a free image. I link the color with the base color and the alpha with the alpha on basic material. This is the result of rendering. If you want to use it with Roblox, you don't need to have this rendering material. You need just to add a plane, and after that you need to export the mesh with export wavefront object, and the last step is to use it into Roblox this plane, and on Roblox to make changes with any texture with alpha blending. In this rendering you can see I need to set alpha clip, because if I don't set this, the image is opaque. And also I can change the clip threshold in order to have more clarity with the image. If you like this tutorial and you like to see more, please subscribe and like it. Also you can follow me on web with my nickname Cutterfest and Midcut. Thank you, bye bye.